Welcome to FieldFox Fundamentals. I'm David Van Werkum. Hey, Jake, what are you doing, man?
I was listening to the radio. Yeah, 100.1 actually.
Really? How are you doing that?
Well, because the FieldFox is a radio receiver, can actually demod analog signals, so you can tune to any AM and FM radio station you want. All you gotta do is tune.
Really? Can you show me how that works?
Yeah, you go mode, SA, measure, and then there's an analog demod tune and listen feature.
So FieldFox can be used as a really fancy radio. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, the only problem is I'm not getting the best reception. It sounds kind of staticky here.
Yeah, that probably makes sense since we're inside. The building's probably distorting the signal a little bit. Why don't we actually take the ideas that we talked about in our last video about channel scanning and go on another little trip and see where around the Keysight campus we can actually get the strongest signal for your favorite radio station?
Let's do it.
Actually, one other thing we can do is I have an iPad and there's a FieldFox app on this iPad that we can remote into the FieldFox and use the GPS on this iPad to track our position as we go about our journey. Let's check it out.
Let's go.
So we're going to clear data, go to settings. So we go hybrid, SA band power marker, set our frequency, tap to send to SA. We want to save the map data as KML, and then we want to make sure we auto mark the map. So now that we've done that, we're saving data.
So the FieldFox is actually in his backpack, so he's doing everything remotely.
Let's check this out. Set map off. We're seeing the FieldFox right there as we walk. So back to map.
Solid minus 40.
That's pretty good power up here. All right, so now that we have the data, we can analyze it in a few different ways. One, we can do what we did in our last video, and that is send the KML data to ourselves and open it on a PC and analyze it using Google Maps or Google Earth. But we can also do that directly on the iPad, and that's going to save us some post-processing. And if we do that, we can take a look at the map and see some things. Namely, we'll notice that as we go outside and get away from the buildings and even get away from the trees, we're going to get a stronger FM signal being received, which makes a lot of sense as there's less interference to distort our signal. And if, for instance, you want to be listening to your FM radio on your FieldFox while working, you might want to pull your desk outside to get that strong signal.
Sounds a little cold. We also learned a couple things about the app. It allows you to remotely connect into the FieldFox, and it allows you to avoid post-processing data by looking at it directly on the iPad.
Yeah, so if you want to take a look at the app, you totally can. It's available on the App Store, and there's a link down in the description. Also, if you enjoyed this video, as well as any of the other videos, you can always like, comment, and subscribe. We'd love to have you do that, and we'll definitely see you next time on FieldFox Fundamentals.